Hello. Let's learn about types of clauses through this presentation. First and foremost, in order to understand types of clauses, we need to clarify the concept of phrases and clauses. Let's understand the difference between a phrase and a clause. Look at this picture and a sentence based on the picture. He is a chef of great repute. Phrases and clauses are groups of words. So here I underline a group of words called of great repute. What we notice in this group of words is that they do not have a well-defined subject and predicate. So they are called a phrase. This group of words is called a phrase because it does not have a well-defined subject and predicate. Let's look at the second sentence. He is a chef who has great repute. If you see, the meaning of the two sentences is not changed. However, you see the structure of the sentence has changed. So you find here who has great repute. And in this group of words, you find that there is a subject, which is who. Since who is related to chef, the who, word who stands for the chef, this is a subject and has is a verb. So, has great repute becomes a predicate. So, this group of words, they have a well-defined subject and a predicate. Therefore, it is a clause. So, we conclude that a phrase does not have well-defined subject and predicate, but a clause is a group of words that consist of a well-defined subject and a predicate. So that's it, the definition of a clause. It's a group of words, it contains well-defined subject and predicate, and also it is a part of a sentence. So now we proceed to learn the different types of clauses. There are mainly three different types of clauses, that is adjective clause, and it's nothing but a group of words with subject and predicate. Now this stands for all the clauses. Group of words with subject and predicate, but their function is different. So adjective clause functions as an adjective. Noun clause is a group of words with subject predicate, but it functions as a noun. And adverb clauses are groups of words with subject and predicate, and they function as adverbs. Now, these are the different types of clauses. Now, we shall see each one in detail and also see how to write their clause analysis. Now we shall see the first one, that is adjective clause. Let's analyze the following sentence. They have a house that is made of wood. Now let's see what is there in this. They have a house. Now in this, if you see, there is a subject, that is they have a house as a predicate. They have a house can stand on its own. It is independent by itself. It does not require anything to complete it. Therefore, this is called an independent clause or a main clause, because a clause is a group of words that have subject and predicate. This has a subject and predicate, and it is a clause which can stand on its own. So it is an independent clause and or a main clause. Let's look at the latter part of the sentence, that is made of wood. Now that is made of wood, it has a subject, which is that. That is a subject because it stands for house. Is a verb, so from is made of wood is a predicate. But, so we know, okay, this is a clause. But the problem is, this is not a full clause in a sense that it requires something before it in order to complete it. So it is dependent on something. So it is called a dependent clause or a subordinate clause. So group of words which have a subject and predicate, but they cannot stand on their own, will be a dependent clause. You cannot have a sentence that is made of wood. So it is not a main clause, it is a dependent clause. Now, if we see here, that is made of wood, it actually qualifies. It is telling you what kind of house. It is telling us what kind of house. Hence, that is made of wood is nothing but an adjective clause, because an adjective clause describes a noun. An adjective describes a noun. It answers the question which or what kind of. It functions. This entire clause functions as an adjective, and therefore this is an adjective clause. Now that we have understood what is an adjective clause, let's look at some examples. The girl who won the prize is my neighbor. So which girl? What kind of girl? Okay. I have a pen which is made of gold. Third sentence, they bought a dog that guards their house. So the girl who won the prize? Which girl who won the prize? I have a pen. What kind of pen? Which is made of gold. They bought a dog. What dog? What does it do? What kind of dog that guards their house? So, what we find here is there are groups of words that are functioning as adjectives. So, in the first sentence, who won the prize? Who is the subject? Won the prize is a predicate. It qualifies the noun girl. That is made of gold. Or which is made of gold? So, which is a subject? Is made of gold is the predicate. It qualifies the noun pen. And the third one, they bought a dog that guards their house. That guards their house. That stands for the dog. Hence, if that is a subject, guards the house is a predicate. Now, the entire clause qualifies the noun dog. So, now how to do the clause analysis for adjective clause? The girl who won the prize is my neighbor. So, how do you write this? The girl is my neighbor is the main clause because the subordinate clause is who won the prize. It's a subordinate adjective clause qualifying the noun girl in the main clause. We have to write it this way in order to do the clause analysis. Look at the second sentence. I have a pen which is made of gold. So, I have a pen. What kind of pen? Which is made of gold. So, the main clause is I have a pen. It's a main clause. You have to specify the main clause when you do clause analysis. And then you write which is made of gold is subordinate adjective clause qualifying the noun pen. It has something to do. It is dependent on something in the main clause. And what is that? The noun pen in the main clause. So, this is how we do clause analysis of adjective clause. Now, we go on to noun clauses. Now, let's first understand the concept of noun clauses, and there are different types of noun clauses which we shall do now. Let's analyze the following sentence. I heard that you have been selected. So, I heard what? That you have been selected. So, I heard something. Okay. Now, here we find that I heard is the independent clause. I heard. Okay. I heard something. I heard something is independent clause or main clause. But what did I hear? That you have been selected. Now, this is a subordinate clause. And it answers the question what. It stands in the place of something. And anything that answers the question what or stands in the place of something is called a noun. So, this is functioning as a noun. Therefore, this group of words is called a noun clause. Let's proceed further. What are the different types of noun clauses? Now, see, these are the different types of noun clauses. Object of a transitive verb, object of a preposition, subject of a verb. So, if you see, these three are nothing but depending on the position of the clause. Either object of transitive verb or object of preposition or subject of a verb. Complement of the verb to be or in apposition to a noun or pronoun. So, now let us see each type in detail. First one, noun clause, object of the transitive verb. Now, we have a video in this channel which is going to tell us the difference between object and complement. So, please go through that video in order to understand what are objects and complements. Now, for now, we'll just understand the noun clause. I heard that they have surrendered. I heard what? That they have surrendered. So, that they have surrendered is actually asking the question what after the verb heard. Now, the verb heard is a transitive verb. We all know that a transitive verb requires an object for the action to be passed over. So, heard is a transitive verb. That they have surrendered is actually in the position of an object. So, this is the object position. So, now this we find that that they have surrendered, the group of words, the noun clause is in the object position, that too after the transitive verb. So, this is called object of the transitive verb or object of the verb. Fine. So that they have surrendered is in the position of an object, and therefore it is object of the transitive verb heard in the main clause. Let's look at some more examples. The first one, I don't know. I don't know what, where she lives. Okay, so this is again object of the transitive verb know. Then second one, they asked what if there was anybody home. So if there was anybody home is the subordinate noun clause, but it is object of the transitive verb asked in the main clause. Similarly, the third one, nobody realized something. What? When the thief escaped. So nobody realized when the thief escaped. When the thief escaped is subordinate clause, object of the transitive verb realized. Fine. So now we go on to the next type of noun clause. Object of the preposition. So now we know that group of words that's come in the place of an object is called object position of a noun clause. But now this is object of the preposition. The previous one was object of the transitive verb, which means it came after the transitive verb. Now here object of the preposition means it will come after the preposition. So let's look at this sentence. Take a look. Much depends on what? What she says. And this what she says is coming after the preposition on. So therefore, this is in the object position. What she says is in the object position, but it is not coming after a verb, but it's coming after a preposition. And hence, it is called object of the preposition. What she says is in the position of an object in a sentence and comes after the preposition on. Hence, this group of words is a noun clause, object of the preposition and not a verb in the main clause. Fine. Now, let's look at some examples. These are some examples here. I thanked him for. For what? What he donated. Object of the preposition, for. Mother was upset with all that they said. Mother was upset with what? All that they said. And all that they said is coming after the preposition with. Therefore, object of the preposition. Third one, he thought about what? How to complete the work. So about is again a preposition. So this is object of the preposition about. This is done. Now we move on to the third type, that is subject of the verb. Well, object comes after or in the latter part of the sentence. Subject takes the primary position in the sentence. It comes in the at the beginning of a sentence. So let's look at this sentence. That you should say so surprises me. Something surprises me. What surprises me? See, the question now is coming at the beginning. What surprises me? That you should say so. And this is a verb. So, this is coming in the subject position or it is coming at the beginning. Therefore, this is called subject of the verb surprises in the main clause. Fine. So that you should say so is in the position of a subject in the sentence and it comes before the verb surprises in the main clause. Hence, it's called noun clause, subject of the verb surprises in the main clause. Let's look at some examples here. What he said was a serious allegation. What was a serious allegation? What he said. Okay. So again, subject of the verb was. Whether there will be exams seems uncertain. What seems uncertain? Whether there will be exams is subject of the verb seems. How they won the trophy is not known. What is not known? How they won the trophy. So this is subject of the verb is in the main clause. Fine. So these three are very simple. So also the next two. Now let's look at the next one. Complement of the verb to be. To be forms are is, are, was, were. And if the clause comes after these verbs, is, are, was, were, then it comes as a complement. It is called a complement of the verb. So this is what they had expected. And is a form of to be. So whenever it comes after is, It will be complement of the verb to be. Fine? So it's in the complement position. You don't call it an object position. When it comes after the verb to be, verb form to be, it is complement, because just to tell you in short, a complement is something that tells you what is the this. Okay? This is what they had expected. It complements the subject. Fine? So here, what they had expected is a complement of the verb is. It's a form of to be in the sentence and comes after the verb form is. Hence, this group of words is a noun clause. Complement of the verb is in the main clause. Some examples. First one, their aim was that people should follow them. Their aim was what? That people should follow them. Death is what? What people seldom understand. Now the third sentence, he is what? What his circumstances have made him. Okay, so this is complement of the verb to be. Now the last type, noun clause in apposition to the noun or pronoun. Now in apposition, not opposition. Opposition would be against. Apposition is related to. Related to the noun or pronoun. So how would it be? Take a look at this sentences. It is a fact. It is a fact, fine, but what is a fact? Fine, that the sun rises in the east. So that the sun rises in the east is telling us what the fact is. So therefore, that the sun rises in the east is an apposition to this noun. It is telling us, it is elaborating the noun. It is expanding the noun. Therefore, it is an apposition to the noun fact. Let's take a look at the next one. They know it, that you are a cop. That you are a cop, fine. They know something. They know it. Alright. Now, this is again in apposition to that it. I could say they know it. But what is that it? So, you're expanding the it. Okay. So, this it is a pronoun. So, you find that when there is an expansion of a word, then it is in apposition to the noun or a pronoun. In sentence 1, that the sun rises in the east is telling what the fact is. Hence, the clause is in apposition to the noun fact. In sentence 2, that you're a cop is telling what the it is. Hence, the clause is in apposition to the pronoun it. Clear? So, let's look at some examples. First one, your belief that he will save you is not true. Your belief. What belief? That he will save you. So you are expanding the word belief. I could easily say your belief is not true. But I am expanding the word belief. That he will save you is in apposition to the noun belief in the main clause. Second one. They passed the verdict that he was not guilty. That he was not guilty is actually the verdict. So what is the verdict? That he was not guilty. So, it is in apposition to the noun verdict in the main clause. It is a lie that you have not taken the pie. It is a lie. What is the lie? Expand the lie that you have not taken the pie. Okay. So, again, this is a noun clause in apposition to the noun lie in the main clause. So, now that you have understood all five types, let's go on to do the clause analysis of noun clause. That she is a dancer is known to all. So what is known? So your question is coming in at the beginning, therefore it is a subject. So let's write this. Something is known to all. So if you feel uncomfortable, you can always write in brackets like this. Something is known to all. Main clause. And what is that? That she is a dancer. Subordinate noun clause. Subject of the verb is in the main clause. Second, the allegation. What allegation? That he is a thief is not proven. So only that he is a thief is the telling us about the allegation, not is not proven. Okay. So that he is a thief, but the rest of it becomes main clause. The allegation is not proven is the main clause, but that he is a thief, subordinate noun clause in apposition to the noun allegation in the main clause. Now let's go on to learn about adverb clauses. Take a look at this sentence. Mary's lamb followed her wherever she went. Okay, so wherever she went. Fine, Mary's lamb followed her. It's a main clause or independent clause. Wherever she went. Let's see whether it answers the question what or what kind of. Mary's lamb followed her what kind of? No, it doesn't answer. So it's not an adjective clause. Mary's lamb followed her what? No, doesn't answer the question what also. Hence, it is not a noun clause. So therefore, it is an adverb clause. But in adverb clause, we need to know the types also. So we'll do that later. Wherever she went. It's a dependent clause or the subordinate clause. And the entire dependent clause adds meaning to the verb followed. Hence, it functions as an adverb. And it answers various questions other than which, what kind of, or what. Okay. So, let's see the different types of adverb clauses. Well, adverbs are of 8 types. So, also adverb clauses, they are of 8 types. Okay. So, we shall see them one by one. See, the sentence all stood when the soldier arrived. All stood when the soldier arrived. Now, this is telling us what time or when they stood up. Okay. So, it's answering the question when after the verb stood. So, therefore, we say this is adverb clause of time because it tells us the time when the soldier arrived. All right. Now, let's look at some examples. The first one, I have been singing since I was a child. Okay. Now, since I was a child, from the beginning, when I have been singing since I was a child, from when? Since I was a child. Next one, they asked the question when? After the bell rang. Okay. So, this is again adverb clause of time modifying the verb asked in the main clause. The police rushed as soon as the thief escaped. Rushed when? As soon as the thief escaped. So, as soon as the thief escaped is a subordinate adverb clause of time modifying. Please note, adverb clauses always modify a verb, adverb, or an adjective. Okay, now we go on to the next type of adverb clause, that is place. You will find it where? Anywhere you search. So it's telling us the place where you're going to find it. Okay. So anywhere you search is going to answer the question where. Okay, on the verb will find. Right, will find where? Anywhere you search. Okay, so therefore it is adverb clause of place modifying the verb will find in the main clause. Look at the following examples. I found it where you told me to search. Wherever they went, they heard about him. Where did they hear about him? Wherever they went. Third one, we took our bags where? Everywhere we went. Okay, so these are adverb clauses of place. Adverb clause of manner, which means how something is done. So see this. He fought as brave men do. He fought how? As brave men do. Okay. So here, as brave men do is adverb clause of manner because it is telling you how or the manner in which the action has been performed. They fought how or he fought how? As brave men do. Hence, it is adverb clause of manner modifying the verb fought in the main clause. Some sentences. I sing just as my mother does. Okay. How do I sing? Just as my mother does. He imitated how? As if he was a mimicry artist. How did he imitate? So and so. Okay. She ran how? Just like a cheetah would. Alright, so these are the ways in which adverb clause of manner is written. Take a look at this now. Third type is done. We're going to the fourth type, adverb clause of condition. Condition means if you do something, then this will happen. So you do it if the teacher asks you to. So you do it, but why would you do it? Only if the, when would you do it? If the teacher asks you to do. So there's a condition. If the teacher doesn't tell you, then you don't do it. Okay. So, do is the verb there. So, we find if the teacher asks you to is adverb clause of condition. Okay. Now, let's look at the examples for this. Unless you are prepared, you should not try. Alright. So, what is the condition for you to try? Unless you are prepared. So, you should be prepared. You should not try. You should work hard even if you fail. Whatever the condition. Okay. Third one. Give him the medicine in case it gets worse or severe. Give him the medicine in what condition? Only if it gets severe. So, in case it gets severe. Okay. Now, we move on to adverb clause of reason or cause. You know, you write the answers, give reasons, no? So, you write why something happens, okay? Or the cause. She came because she had some work. She came. Why? Because she had some work. So, therefore, this is answering the question why an action took place or the reason for an action to take place. Hence, it is adverb clause of reason modifying the verb came in the main clause. Now, for example, take a look at the first one. I sing, but why do I sing? As it is my passion. Second one, since you did me a favor, I will help you. Why will I help you? Since you did me a favor. Okay. The police rushed. Why did they rush? Because a thief escaped. See, in the previous sentence, it was the police rushed as soon as the thief escaped. That is a time. Here you are saying, why did the police rush? Because a thief escaped. So, this is the reason you are giving for something to happen. Okay. So, as, since, because, etc. are used as adverb clauses of reason. Now, let's see the next one. Adverb clause of concession. Okay. Or contrast. Concession or contrast. Which means the first part is saying something. The second part is in contrast to that. Something is happening. There is a concession or a contrast happening. Let's see the first sentence. All stood. Though they were not asked to. So, see the contrast. All stood. But what is the thing? They were not asked to. Okay. So, they were not asked to. So, there is a contrast or concession. So, when there is something like that, though, although, then you find that there is a contrast in the action stood. Okay. So, answers the question, why is the action unexpected after the verb? Why is it unexpected? Because they were not asked to. Though they were not asked to. So, this is adverb clause of concession. Modifying the verb stood in the main clause. Take a look at the next one. The examples. The first one. He spoke even though nobody listened. So what's the contrast? He spoke fine. But what's the opposite of that? Even though nobody listened. Okay, next one. Although she ran, she missed the train. So see the contrast. She ran, but she missed the train. So although she ran. Though, although, these are cue words for you. The people rushed, but the sale was over. Though the sale was over. Okay. So, though the sale was over is adverb clause of concession modifying the verb rushed in the main clause. Take a look at this now. Adverb clause of purpose. We go on to adverb clause of purpose. So, purpose is not the same as reason. Reason will tell you why something happened. Purpose is an action is done for what result, okay? So, for what aim or a bigger aim? All stood. What's the purpose? So that. So, you will find the cue words are so that they could see the picture. Okay? All stood so that they could see the picture. So, the cue word is so that. Okay? And again, the verb is stood. Alright? So that they could see the picture tells about the purpose of the action stood. The clause answers the question for what, not why. All stood for what? So that they could see the picture. So ask the right questions. All stood why? So that they could see the pictures. Wrong. All stood for what? So that they could. So this is adverb clause of reason. Another purpose, another way to identify is the cue words so that used together. Okay. Examples. See this? She sings so that she can feed her children. Next one, he coached her in order that. So, you could use even in order that. she gets the medal. So even this is a adverb clause of purpose. And the third one, she studied hard. For what purpose? For what? In order that. So in order that and so that should give you clues about what type of adverb clause it is. It is adverb clause of purpose and not reason. Now we go on to adverb clause of result. Now result is a little unique because it is in two parts. Let's see how. He was so something that he could not run further. Okay. So see, he was so tired. There is something coming in between due to which the other result happening. There is a result happening afterwards. Okay. So here the verb is was, and how do you write this? So dash 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 that he could not run further. It tells about the consequence. Why? What happened? Because he was tired that he could not run further. The consequence of the action. Okay. Now he was so tired. Tired is an adjective. So the consequence of that adjective is what? That he could not run further. Okay. So this group of words is an adverb clause of result, modifying the verb was tired in the main clause. Or you could also say modifying the adjective tired in the main clause. So for some examples, first one, they were fooled such a way that they never realized. Okay, now see such and a way. All right, now were fooled is the verb. Next, they asked such questions that no one could answer. All right, such, they asked such questions that no one could answer. So asked questions, asked is the verb because questions is a noun. So you cannot have adverb clause modifying nouns. Okay. So, but they asked in such a manner that no one could answer. She's so powerful. So, adjective powerful. Okay. That she commands respect. Right. So, now that you have understood all the types of adverb clauses, see, look at this. We have also provided all the different types of cue words which will help you to recognize the various adverb clauses and their types. Okay, so you know the cue words are here. You can understand from this mind map what are the various cue words that can help you to recognize the various adverb clauses. Now let's see the analysis, clause analysis. Mary's lamb followed wherever she went. You will write it as Mary's lamb followed, main clause, and wherever she went, subordinate adverb clause of place. You have to mention here modifying the verb followed in the main clause. Second one, he's so foolish that all laugh at him. So, and that all laugh at him. So it becomes he is foolish, main clause, but so dash 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 that all laugh at him. Subordinate adverb clause of result. Modifying the verb is, or you can say, adjective foolish in the main clause. So let's revise now. I'm giving you three sentences. All right. Now see, these are the three sentences. We are going to see what clause they are and their breakup. Okay. Let's see this. I have a book that is a bestseller. I have a book that is a bestseller. Will it come? Where will it come? It will be an adjective clause. Okay. I have a book that is a bestseller, qualifying the noun book. The first one, that is the second sentence. It is a superstition that black cats are bad omen. It is a superstition, but please expand the superstition for me. Okay. So you're expanding the supervision that black cats are bad omen. It is in apposition to the noun superstition. And the last one, they worked hard so that they may pass. They worked hard for what? See, I gave you the cue word is so that for the purpose. Okay. They worked hard by, so that, for what? So that they may pass. Adverb clause of purpose, modifying the verb, worked in the main clause. So this is all about adverb clauses and their types and the various clauses also, noun clause, adjective clauses and adverb clauses. So hope you have understood. So thank you for your attention.